all the conditions of Langrande's mean value theorem. And therefore, by LMVT, we can say that there exists some constant, therefore, there exists some C in the interval a to x such that fx minus f of a upon x minus a is equal to f dash of c, is equal to f dash of c. But just now we have proved that f dash x is equal to p for every x. So this is equal to p. So what I have proved actually is fx minus f of a is equal to p into x minus a, taking this x minus a on the right hand side. So this proves that fx is equal to px minus pa plus f of a. And as you notice that this is a constant, let us call this constant as q. So therefore, what we have proved is fx is equal to px plus q for every x belongs to close interval ab. Because what was x there? X was any element in the close interval ab. So we have obtained that formula. If a function f is twice differentiable and second derivative is 0 for every x in the closed interval ab, then fx is equal to px plus q is the formula. The function must be this linear function in one variable. Okay. So this is the solution of this problem. Now let us go to the next one. You can see on your screen the next problem. Show that the chord of the curve y square is equal to px plus q, joining the two points x equal to a and x equal to b on it, is parallel to the tangent to the curve at the point x is equal to a plus b by 2. So let us see first of all this by this figure. This is the graph of say y is equal to x square plus px plus q, and we take two points a and b on this curve, and the question is the chord joining these two. Chord means the line segment joining the two distinct points on the curve. Chord joining these two points is parallel to at least one tangent t at some point, and that some point we want to show is a plus b by 2. A plus b by 2. Suppose this point a has the coordinates a comma f of a. So this thing is a, and for b, suppose the coordinates are b comma f of b, b comma f of b. So this is b, and now we recall that Langrande's theorem. Or let us consider this way: f from closed interval a b. I have taken two points a and b on the curve, and I am defining or considering the function f from closed interval a b to R as fx is equal to x square plus px plus q. Consider this function. Then f is everywhere continuous, everywhere differentiable, because it is a polynomial function. Therefore, we can use LMVT, and by LMVT, there exists a constant between a and b, means in the open interval a b, such that fb minus f of a upon b minus a is equal to f dash c. Now let us understand this left hand side here. This left hand side fb minus fa upon b minus a is slope of the line, slope of the line joining the two points a and b, or slope of the chord joining the two points a and b. Here the a has coordinates a comma f of a, b has coordinates b comma f of b. The slope of this line segment is difference in y coordinates fb minus fa upon difference in x coordinates b minus a, and it is equal to f dash c. What is f dash c? Geometrical meaning of f dash c is slope of slope of this tangent line t. Okay, now what is f of b? F of b is, by putting x equal to b in this equation, we get slope means f of b is b square plus p into b plus q minus f of a by putting in the function formula, we get a square plus p into a plus q upon b minus a is equal to f dash c. What is f dash c? Since the function was fx is equal to x square plus px plus q, this was the function, derivative is 2x plus p, and derivative at the point c, that is f dash c, is 2 into c plus p, 2 into c plus p. Okay, now let us simplify this. If you simplify, then qq will be cancelled, and b square minus a square plus p into b minus a upon b minus a is equal to 2c plus p, is equal to 2c plus p. Now what is this simplification? This implies it is b plus a plus p, cancelling b minus a, is equal to 2c plus p. So this pp gets cancelled and you will get c is equal to a plus b by 2. So that f dash c is the slope of t at the point c is equal to a plus b by 2. So as you can see on the screen, that figure, this is the curve y is equal to x square plus px plus q. Next, joining the two points a and b, you get a chord AB, and that point c we have obtained here, c is equal to a plus b by 2, and at this point the tangent, next, the tangent at this c is equal to a plus b by 2 is parallel to the chord AB. So the theorem, that result is proved. Okay, and now let us go to the last problem. It is also a very interesting one. You can see on the screen, if f is differentiable, twice differentiable, and second derivative is greater than or equal to 0. F dash x is greater than or equal to 0, double dash x greater than 0 for every x, then prove that f of x plus y by 2 less than or equal to fx plus fy by 2. Okay, here f is a function from R to R, and this is given. Let us choose any two elements, xy belongs to R, and suppose x is less than y. So this is our real line and two points. Then we know that x plus y by 2 always lies between x and y. That is, we have x less than x plus y by 2 less than y. Okay. So this gives us the two intervals, this and x plus y by 2 to y. Okay. Since f double dash x exists, that means f is differentiable everywhere, and f is also continuous everywhere according to the data. Therefore, by data, f is continuous on close interval x to x plus y by 2, and also differentiable, or rather say continuous and differentiable on the close interval x to x plus y by 2, and also it is continuous and differentiable on this interval. So I can apply the Langevin's theorem on this interval as well as on this interval. So by LMVT, for the first interval here, there exists some constant c1 between x comma x plus y by 2, such that f of x plus y by 2 minus f of x upon b minus a, that b minus a I am writing here, b minus a means x plus y by 2 minus x. Actually, it should be here fb minus fa upon b minus a, but that b minus a I am taking on this right hand side, into f dash of what? C1. Okay. And if you simplify this, you will get f of x plus y by 2 minus f of x is equal to y minus x by 2 times f dash of c1. This is number 1. Similarly, applying Langevin's theorem on this interval, we can find c2 here. So there exists c2 in open interval x plus y by 2 to y, such that you will get f of y minus f of x plus y by 2 is equal to fb minus fa upon b minus a, that is y minus x plus y by 2 into f dash of c2. Okay, and if you simplify this, this gives you y minus x by 2 again. And let us call this as result number 2. So you observe the two results, 1 and 2. Now taking the difference of 1 and 2, taking 1 minus 2, we get, see, where is 1? This one. This minus this. So, this minus this, this will become plus, and this is the same term. So, it is 2 times f of x plus y by 2, and this minus this means minus fx and minus fy minus fx minus fy is equal to, here this is a common factor, so y minus x by 2 is common, into bracket you will get f dash of c1 minus f dash of c2, f dash of c1 minus f dash of c2. Okay, so this is the thing, and let us consider this as equation number 3. Now again you see that I can apply Lagrange theorem for the function f dash. See, f dash x is also differentiable because we are given in the hypothesis that f double dash exists. As f double dash exists, f dash is differentiable everywhere. And therefore, f dash of c1 minus f dash of c2 you can replace by LMVT f dash of c3 into b minus c2 minus c1 or c1 minus c2. Let me rewrite it. Applying f dash for the interval c1 c2 to R, okay, we get some c3 in the open interval c1 comma c2 such that f dash of c1 minus f dash of c2 upon c1 minus c2 is equal to f dash is equal to f double dash of c3. We are applying the theorem for f dash. So this is f dash here, and the derivative of f dash is f double dash. But f double dash c3 is what? Positive. So this implies f dash c1 minus f dash c2 is negative because c1 is less than c2. So if you multiply by c1 minus c2 both the sides, inequality changes. So you will get this value negative. This value is negative means this number is negative. So from 3 we get 2 into f of x plus y by 2 minus fx plus fy is less than 0, is less than 0, and that proves our result, that is f of x plus y by 2 is less than fx plus fy upon 2. Okay, and since x and y are arbitrary, this is true for every x and y belongs to R. Okay, so we have obtained this interesting result using the Lagrange's theorem. So I have discussed some 5-6 interesting problems based on the two mean value theorems, Rolle's theorem and the Lagrange's mean value theorem. Now I request our next speaker, Gaurangi Prajapati, to again discuss some more problems about mean value theorem.
Good afternoon. To prove, તમે તમારી સ્ક્રીન પર જોઈ શકો છો, to prove 2 upon pi is less than equal to sin x upon x is less than 1 for 0 is less than mod x is less than pi by 2. So first we prove this result for 0 is less than x is less than pi by 2. Now first I define fx as a sin x upon x whenever 0 is less than x is less than pi by 2 and is equal to 1 whenever x is equal to 0. Now obviously this is a continuous function on close interval 0 pi by 2. At x is equal to 0, limit x tends to 0 from right hand side fx is equal to limit x tends to 0 sin x upon x and is equal to 1 and is equal to f of 0. And so obviously it is continuous at x is equal to 0. So this function sin x upon x is a continuous on closed interval 0 by 2. Now what is f dash x? F dash x is equal to x cos x minus sin x. We can write this as a cos x upon x square in the bracket x minus tan x. Now we know this, for 0 is less than x is less than pi by 2, x is less than tan x. And so since cos x is positive in this interval, x square is positive, but x minus tan x is negative, so this implies f plus x is negative, is less than 0. So by Lagrange, the application of Lagrange mean value theorem, function f is a decreasing function in this interval 0, pi by 2. So f is a decreasing function in interval 0, pi by 2. And so whenever 0 is less than x is less than pi by 2, this implies since it is a decreasing function, f0 is greater than fx is greater than f pi by 2. Now we define f0 as a 1, so 1 is greater than fx is sin x upon x is greater than sin pi by 2 upon pi by 2, sin pi by 2 is 1, so it's 2 upon pi. Now we prove this result in interval 0 pi by 2. Now to prove, now whenever x is between this minus pi by 2 is less than x is less than 0, and this implies 0 is less than minus x is less than pi by 2. So here minus x is between 0 and pi by 2, so we apply the above result, and so I write f0, so I write
sin less than
0. So 1 is less than, using this result, so 2 upon pi.